If you head west from the city of Naples, you will begin to see large craters, altered regions, and calderas in the ground representing vents of the Campi Flegrei volcano, which to some scientists is just barely classified as a supervolcano. I am giving an update on this debated supervolcano as something has notably changed since the beginning of the month. Specifically, the ground has started to rise on a section of the volcano at an elevated rate of 57 centimeters or 22.4 inches a year, marking its highest rate of land rise in 40 years. Why is this worrying? Simply put, the last time such a high level was reached and maintained for a decent amount of time was in 1984, and that resulted in the evacuation of more than 40,000 people. Campi Flegrei, which I personally rank as the fifth most potentially dangerous volcano in the world, has a history of powerful explosive eruptions, and while it has produced very small eruptions in the past, any future eruption would be incredibly dangerous due to how densely populated the area is today. Campi Flegrei has been at a raised alert level of yellow since December of 2016, and every year since then, there has seemingly been a slow but steady year-over-year increase in activity. The ground uplift is caused by underground magma slowly ascending from 8 to 3 kilometers depth beneath the Solfatara site, where it then expands into a laccolith-like seal that displaces and domes overlying rock. Since there is significant heat present above the magma chamber, underground hydrothermal fluids are heated and expand in volume, which causes adjacent faults to slip, generating swarms of earthquakes. The number of earthquakes which occur is largely linked to the rate of ground deformation at the time. This might be why, in the last month, two strong earthquake swarms have occurred involving Campi Flegrei's second and fifth largest volcano tectonic earthquakes on record. Although we only have a brief dataset to work with, so there could be a large margin of error, between April 5th and April 20th, 23.75 millimeters of uplift occurred. If this rate were to continue for a year, it would surpass the maximum rate witnessed during two of Campi Flegrei's three 20th century seismic crises. Yet, there is some good news. Across the last 2 years, Campi Flegrei has been undergoing intermittent rates of uplift and even some subsidence, ranging from negative 1 to 18 centimeters a year for weeks to months at a time, and occasionally, this is seemingly interrupted by a short burst of greatly heightened uplift. This is exactly what occurred in September of last year, and that only lasted for a week before returning to normal levels. I am suggesting that the same might occur here in the next month, but if this does not occur and the rate of uplift maintains at a high level, then Campi Flegrei might already be in a new seismic crisis period. For context, seismic crises represent brief, several-year-long periods where ground uplift rises from less than 18 centimeters a year to between 35 and 370 centimeters a year. Such periods result in highly frequent small magnitude earthquakes, with the uplift itself sometimes leading to building damage. Why exactly might a building be damaged? Simply put, structures are not necessarily designed to be pushed upwards by several meters in an uneven manner, which can potentially cause cracks to form or even foundation damage. This, combined with an increased rate of magnitude 3 to 4 earthquakes, was why an evacuation occurred in 1984 rather than a high risk of a volcanic eruption suddenly occurring. While it is true that the risk of a volcanic eruption progressively increases the higher the rate of uplift there is, I have a legitimate reason to suspect that a volcanic eruption won't occur anytime soon unless the rate of uplift further increases. First of all, magma does not yet exist at shallow enough depths to directly trigger an eruption in my opinion, like last occurred in 1538. Instead, in the five-step cycle Campi Flegrei seems to undergo, we are merely in step 3, a period of heightened ground deformation where an eruption is highly unlikely. I would only be concerned about an eruption becoming possible if ground deformation for more than 12 months exceeded 2 meters a year, like last witnessed in 1537 to 1538, where some areas reportedly rose by as much as 9.1 meters or 30 feet a year. In summary, a new seismic crisis similar to what Campi Flegrei experienced between 1982 and 1985 may now be ongoing once again, but a volcanic eruption anytime soon, in my opinion, seems highly unlikely. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.